Welcome to the President's Diary, where we take a look at His Excellency Dr. Muhammad Irfaan Ali's week of activities. His Excellency Dr. Irfaan Ali, President of the Cooperative Republic of Guyana and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces, Sunday morning attended the Remembrance Day ceremony at the War Memorial Cenotaph Monument in Georgetown.
Meet again to remember all those gallant men and women who gave their lives in two world wars. We are forever indebted to them for their supreme sacrifice in the cause of peace and freedom. We also recall with gratitude those who through the years have made similar personal sacrifices in a continuing struggle for human dignity, social justice, and freedom from all forms of oppression, wherever these exist. Their example strengthens our resolve to maintain our efforts for a world at peace, with justice and prosperity for all peoples. This solemn occasion, we, the citizens of the Cooperative Republic of Guyana, rededicate ourselves to the search for peace everywhere and renew our commitment to the development and well-being of our beloved country.
The head of state met with an executive team from the renowned New York-based Mount Sinai Health System Monday afternoon at the Artichoke Conference Center.
President Ali was joined by Vice President, the Honorable Dr. Bara Jagdeo, and Minister of Health, the Honorable Dr. Frank Anthony. Discussion centered on the modernization of Guyana's healthcare system. The visiting delegation included Mount Sinai International President, Sabolks Dorotovix, Senior Vice President of Medical Affairs, Richard Amarayan, Executive Vice President Dr. Arthur Klein, and Manager Amar Danraj. After the meeting, Dr. Klein said that healthcare would be key as Guyana continues to develop.
On Tuesday, President Ali had several engagements, starting with executive members of the National Spiritual Assembly of the Baha'is of Guyana at the office of the President on Shiv Chandrapal Drive.
The head of state discussed the community building activities of local Baha'is, while he also received a special religious book which observes the century of the ascension of Abul Baha, one of the three central figures of the Baha'i faith. The president extended his gratitude to the group and promised to read the book. He also offered his office's support for further community building activities, especially towards the education of youths and school dropouts.
His Excellency Dr. Muhammad Irfaan Ali also met with the United States Ambassador to Guyana, Sarah Ann Lynch, and an executive team from Bechtel, an American engineering, procurement, construction, and project management company.
The head of state was joined by Vice President, the Honorable Dr. Bara Jagdeo, and Minister within the Ministry of Public Works, the Honorable Deodat Indar. The visiting team featured President for Regions and Corporate Relations of Bechtel, Stuart Jones, Global Manager of Business Development, Jamie McMillan, and the Global Manager of Strategy and Marketing and Business Development, Andrew Patterson. The meeting took place at the office of the President on Shiv Chandrapal Drive. Bechtel has helped customers complete more than 25,000 projects in 160 countries on all seven continents.
The head of state met with a team of local entrepreneurs and foreign investors later that day at the office of the President on Shiv Chandrapal Drive.
His Excellency was joined by Vice President, the Honorable Dr. Bara Jagdeo, and CEO of the Guyana Office for Investment, Dr. Peter Ramsarup. CEO of Brandt Inc., Rick Brandt, who was one of the foreign investors at the meeting, said that the agriculture market, building infrastructure and energy, including power plants and renewable energy, were among some of the areas discussed. He called the overall meeting great and said that the president was very responsive and positive with the developmental ideas.
On Wednesday, His Excellency Dr. Muhammad Irfaan Ali received a courtesy visit from the non-resident ambassador of Ireland to Guyana, Sean Hoy.
The visit took place at the office of the president on Shiv Chandrapal Drive. Ambassador Hoy, who was accredited on September 11, 2019, is Ireland's first ambassador to Guyana. The two countries established diplomatic relations on February 2, 2000.
Also on Wednesday, His Excellency Dr. Muhammad Irfaan Ali hosted a luncheon in honor of the visiting members of the United States National Bar Association and prominent members of the local legal fraternity at State House.
The president also engaged in discussions with the visiting officials, including the president of the NBA, Judge Carlos Moore, Chief Foreign Policy Advisor Johanna LeBlanc, JD, LLM, Executive Director Morris Foster, ESC, and member of the South Carolina House of Representatives, Rosalind Henderson Myers. Prime Minister, Brigadier Retired, the Honorable Mark Phillips, Attorney General and Minister of Legal Affairs, the Honorable Anil Nandlal, Minister of Foreign Affairs and International Cooperation, the Honorable Hugh Todd, and Foreign Secretary Robert Prasad were joined by representatives of the local media fraternity, such as the Acting Chancellor of the Judiciary, Yonet Cummings Edwards, Acting Chief Justice Roxanne George Wiltshire, Director of Public Prosecutions Shalimar Ali Haq, and President of the Guyana Bar Association Pauline Chase.
His Excellency Dr. Muhammad Irfaan Ali said that his government is pleased to partner with the International Energy Conference and Expo for the four-day event scheduled for mid-February in Guyana.
Quote, "We believe that the multifaceted nature of the conference is in keeping with the national drive for holistic development and investment opportunities of Guyana."
The government will actively contribute to the conference at the level of the President, the Honorable Vice President Dr. Bara Jagdeo, and other members of the Cabinet. The head of state added that the government is pleased that other global agencies will participate in various discussion sessions ranging from energy, oil and gas, climate change, and food security. His Excellency Dr. Muhammad Irfaan Ali accepted the letters of credence on Friday from Ambassador of the Swiss Federal Council to Guyana, Dr. Herg Spreiser, while stating that he is looking forward to greater bilateral relations between the two countries.
The head of state said Guyana and Switzerland have enjoyed very cordial relations. The new non-resident ambassador's appointment allows the two countries to strengthen those relations further.
We look forward to collaborating with the government of Switzerland to explore areas for a more active approach to our bilateral agenda, especially in the areas of technical cooperation, and
the ambassador will also be accredited to CARICOM as the Swiss representative to the Caribbean community.
His Excellency Dr. Muhammad Irfaan Ali met with an executive team from Huawei at the office of the president on Shiv Chandrapal Drive Friday afternoon.
The visitors included Huawei's president for Central America and the Caribbean, Chen Peng, vice president for Latin America, Zhu Feng, CEO for the Caribbean office, Jing Zhen Feng, and the Director of Public Relations for Central America and the Caribbean, Chen Yu. Huawei is a leading global provider of information and communications technology, infrastructure, and smart devices.
That's it for this week's President Diary, where we took a look at His Excellency Dr. Muhammad Irfaan Ali's week of activities. Thank you for watching, and do join us again next week. Goodbye.